因为我们今年遇到比较多球员的变化嘛，那就整个暑假都一直在做球员的整合啦。那当然我们是的计划不是说一年嘛，我们是把我们的目标跟教练一起谈好是这个三年计划。那当然是希望年轻球员成长，然后老将带着年轻球员去更了解真正职业的生态是怎么样。那当然每一支球队都会的计划都想要赢更多场球嘛，那当然我们也是，可是我们不会因为可能把火力集中在一两年就把它烧完，我们是希望我们是可以很长远的走啦。一胜十九败就是唯一赢的那一场，我还没有去看到，所以我看了一整年都没有赢球，就很痛苦。可是也正是因为这样，未来就是后来我们一开始赢球，那个我们就比较了解这个中间的辛苦啦，也知道职业篮球真的没有那么简单，然后慢慢调整，慢慢调整。那现在就是希望我们可以再把每一场球都表现到最好这样子，因为毕竟我们现在可能真的从今年开始平均年龄层突然大幅下降很多，但是我们也有许多中生代，像德威啊、松卫。其实我的目标是希望梦想家三年至少可以拿一个冠军。
It's kind of the way that I've been brought up on the game. It's the way that I've been trying to coach, you know, for my professional coaching career. You know, I just think that in Taiwan, there's really good skills. You know, the players have great skills, passing and shooting. They're very quick. There's not a lot of size or athleticism. So I just think that, you know, playing quick and getting to spots quickly and having a system built on some flow, I think is probably one of the better ways to play, especially for our roster. I don't like that only because, in my opinion, the Rockets were based on, you know, one player holding the ball a lot. I'm trying to create an equal opportunity offense, right? Really, space the floor and you take the best open shot. You don't, you know, not from one player. I think if you look at our players today, everybody was shooting kind of like an equal amount of threes and things like that. I don't love the Rockets comparison, but at the same time, you know, we do shoot a lot of threes. You know, 45 to 50% of our shots are from threes, so it makes sense that people would make that comparison. But I'm trying to create a system that's more equal. I have a very specific process for my culture building. It's called 20 steps. I have 20 steps, and I try and follow those every day and try and build it up. It starts with togetherness. You know, but you also have to have the players that have the mindset. I think we've done a good job of assembling those players. I think that our older players do a good job of bringing that, you know, to practice every day and cultivating the young players. But I also think our young players have it as well. So we go from togetherness to toughness. And then the big thing is the way we train. We try and be in great shape. I think that if you're in great shape, very similar to the Miami Heat, if you're in great shape, then you can play at a high level for 48 minutes, and you can play quickly, and you can make shots, and play the game, and space. So a lot of it is built on, you know, my cultural process is built on conditioning, togetherness, and toughness. You know, so this is my second year. Last year I started, right, and it didn't really work well last year. The group was different, the mindset was different. I think through the course of last season until now, I think we have a better feel, better players, and the players are better fit, and now it's working better. But it takes a long time. Day by day, there's lots of ups and there's lots of downs. You know, when you shoot a lot of threes, it's not going to go in every night. You're going to have some off nights. So it's just a daily process.
SBL 过去在很多地方的一些执行面上，可能包含球迷也可以看到一些讨论。那其实确实可能不是这么的好。那其实，在 P 联盟来讲的话，我今天有一次参加他们的裁判会议。我们那天在台北住宿的时候，刚好有一个情况，有一个裁判主动跑过来，他跟我们讨论说他当天的判决，他跟我们过来承认说他判错了，然后跟我们看影片。虽然说那个时候我们在判决上我们是得理的，但是他会主动跑过来跟我们承认他的错误，然后跟我们去达成一个共识，说嘿，其实以后的情况之下，裁判组这边会更清楚的一个判决，一个明确的判决。那这个真的是一个蛮特别的经验，因为其实过去我在 SBL 从来不会遇到这样的事情，因为可能裁判可能判完了就判完了，他们不会再去做后续的一些检讨讨论。那我会觉得说，在这个联盟来讲的话，光是裁判这一块，他们想建立的一个情况是，裁判、球员跟教练，他们不是对立的关系，他们是 co-worker。这沟通部分当然是都还算正常，因为其实我自己本身在当初在国外念书的时候，我是学美式篮球， 所以在整个这样观念的沟通上来讲，其实都不会有太大的差距。那当然，比较会可能压力会比较大一点，就是因为他可能因为外国教练的话，他们其实好会教得很细，那可是就是变成说我不需要很快在很短的时间之内把教练重要的观念交到给球员，所以在翻译的过程中，当然会多少会压力会有点大，但是还是要尽可能做到尽善尽美。而且其实，因为语言能够沟通的情况之下，我跟教练等于说我们互动彼此聊天的时间很多，所以也能够更了解他的体系的情况之下，当然能够帮助球员们能够更了解他的要求在哪里。
It's pretty easy. I have a group of coaches that help me with it, so we're able to coordinate a good training program together. It is what it is. Nicknames are usually given by other people. You don't get to choose them. So, I'm fine with it as long as the fans are having fun with it. Yeah, I mean, it's different everywhere you go. Taiwan is a lot faster. There's typically smaller guys, so you have to play a lot faster. The U.S., there's a lot bigger guys, a lot stronger guys, so the physicality is a little different in each place. It's just something I've been really good at since I was young, being able to change speeds, going fast, going slow, never letting the defense decide how I'm going to play.